are you doing? I hope you're all well. So today I decided to make a video explaining what roles are good to do prior to completing your degree and trying to get into a social work job as a professional social worker. I've had a number of my subscribers ask me this question, so I just feel like I'm probably better off just doing a video so that if later on other people want to ask me questions, I don't need to respond to that question anymore, because it'll be in a video. So yeah, I hope this video is helpful. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoy it and subscribe if you haven't already, and thank you to all my new subscribers as well. Okay, let's get right into it. So basically, for those of you who might be new to my channel, I am a social worker and I've been practicing since I think I graduated around the end of 2013. I think it was 2012. Yeah, end of 2012. And I've been working as a social worker since then. So yeah, currently I'm a social worker in a domestic violence position. My role description is like an intake counselor, but I am still a social worker. So prior to me getting into social work, the jobs that I had done, that had given me a little bit of experience before I started practicing social work was I did youth work, where I was like a youth support worker. I worked with kids that were removed out of their parents' homes due to safety concerns, or there was a wide range of issues. And so basically, as a youth worker, I was supporting them physically, emotionally, and mentally as well. So things that I would do would include like taking them to their appointments, teaching them daily living skills like cooking, doing activities with them, and just supporting them emotionally when the need arises. So these kids that I worked with lived in group homes as well. Other jobs that I did were like I did customer service just over the phone. I worked for like a phone service, and I also did like face-to-face customer service when I worked at the library. So basically, that was all the experience that I had prior to me getting into a job as a social worker. But I think the one that probably helped me the most to be more comfortable in my role as a social worker was youth support work, because it was very similar to the role of a social worker. Well, I mean, it's not very similar, but it does give you the basis of what the basic skills you would require when you become a social worker. So basically, I don't really want to suggest specific roles to you guys, but I'm just going to give you some tips that you can go by when you're looking for a job that would prepare you before you become a social worker, because I feel like it's those skills that's important. So even if the job that you're doing right now is not necessarily it's not necessarily related to a social work role where you're working with someone who has experienced some kind of trauma or anything, you can still relate it, because that's the most important thing. Like if you go to an interview, a lot of people think, you know, when people say experience is required and stuff like that, people always think that you actually have to have experience in a similar role, but not necessarily. So long as you're able to explain how the previous skills and knowledge that you have, you can use it in the new role, you know, the people that are interviewing you can't challenge that, because that's what they're looking for, is the skills that they're looking for. So if you're able to assert yourself about how you can use the skills you've learned from a previous role in this new role, then you shouldn't really have a problem. So I think first of all, you need to have really good communication skills as a social worker. So if you've watched my skills you require to become a social worker, you would see that I have things like active listening skills, like paraphrasing, empathy, all that stuff. That's all really important stuff that you require in being a social worker, because you do work with people that have experienced some kind of trauma majority of the time. So you require that kind of skills in order to understand them better and in order to be able to help them the best way possible. So with active listening skills, you don't necessarily have to have had experience in like a support work role or something like that. You could just be doing customer service, maybe in retail or over the phone or whatever it is, and you can still use those kind of skills that you've learned in practicing social work if you became a social worker later on. I'm not sure if that makes sense, but yeah, that's what I'm driving at. Another thing I would say is if you're having to do any form of notes or report writing in your current role, that's another thing that, you know, you can take with you when you attend an interview for a social work job, because most of the time in practicing social work, you'll be doing some report writing, you'll be doing some case note writing, you'll be doing some support letter writing, all that stuff. So obviously when I did youth support work, I was required to do case notes at the end of it every day, at the end of my shift. So that's something that I put on my resume, and that's something that I talked about in my interview, because that's something that I currently use as a social worker as well. So in this kind of case, you may be working in, I don't know, some kind of administrative role where you're required to put together reports and things like that, and your ability to do that can be taken into consideration when you're wanting to become a social worker. And that comes, you know, that relates to being able to be organized and all that stuff. And those are all skills that are required when you become a social worker as well. So that's something that you can take with you as well. Also, basic skills like respect, punctuality, being assertive, all that stuff. Those are all skills that are required of you as a social worker. These are all not skills that you need to be in a support work role, or, you know, some role that relates to a social worker in order for you to get. You can get it in other roles that have nothing to do with social work. You can learn to become assertive in being a customer service representative, or in doing like sales, being a salesperson where you're having to sell products to people. Obviously, you have to be assertive. Not everyone is nice. You have to learn how to speak to people in such a way that they're interested in what you have to say and all that stuff. Those are all skills that you can bring to social work. So I hope, like, I didn't want this video to be like really directed where I'm telling you what kind of roles will get you a social work job fast. I feel like if you understand what skills are required of you, then you can relate whatever role you're in to those skills, and that would help you in your interviews to become a social worker. One last point that I want to make is, I did mention earlier on that social workers tend to work with people that have experienced some kind of trauma. Now, if you're doing customer service, you do not necessarily know the customers that you're working with in that sense. Like, you don't really know what their background is around those things. So, and that's why the people skills is important. But that is something that you can also bring into an interview, because you can talk about how you work with all kinds of people. People that are quite nice, people that can be difficult, people that might have some behavioral issues. And, you know, you can talk about how you handle that. And how you usually handle that is usually being non-judgmental, being assertive, responding respectfully, knowing what your job requires of you, knowing what your role is, you know. And those are all skills that you can bring into social work. So yeah, I hope this video is really, really helpful, and I hope you can learn one or two things from it, and you can take it into interviews that you go to later on, when you need to, when you're trying to get a social work job or something. Yeah, so subscribe if you haven't already, and if you enjoyed this video, and I guess I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys.